заканчиваю встречу по вольной борьбе между командами России.
Welcome to the SKK Sports Complex here in St. Petersburg, Russia. This is the most beautiful city I've ever seen, and it is my great pleasure to be here with you for the Sport Accord World Combat Games. Today, we have the great gift of watching the men's freestyle team finals. I am Robin Black from Fight Network in Canada, and very shortly, I will be joined by Rich Tatto, former Pancration World Champion. He is currently a USA collegiate wrestling coach. It's going to be my pleasure to have an expert sitting next to me, but very much looking forward to this. There you see the world team. This is Russia versus the world. Different weight divisions will compete. Seven different weight divisions, each one featuring a Russian wrestling athlete against a superstar in the world of wrestling. First one, the first team to win four matches will win. If one of the teams reaches four wins before the seven are complete, we will go through and see all 14 men compete. The art of freestyle wrestling, an incredible sport. Really one of the first sports that existed. Two men, two prehistoric men, men of any walk of life from the beginning of time have tried to see which one could be dominant and put the other one on his back. But the art has evolved to such a high level now. It's always been about strength and speed and explosiveness. But there's so much detail in technique. And that's why I'm going to be pleased to have Rich Tatto here to help us break it down today. Each of the men will say hello. They know each other well, all of these men. The Russian team at different weight divisions have competed against each other or trained with each other, and the international guys. These gentlemen have been competing at the highest level throughout the world since they were young men. It is a very physical sport. But you find a lot of real gentlemen in the sport of freestyle wrestling. Those are the big ones. So a Russian man will compete against a wrestler from another area of the world team. The first four to win out of the seven matches will win. Coaches say hello. They've known each other for a long time. It's a real camaraderie in this sport, but when they get in here, it is as physically explosive of a type of combat as you can see anywhere in the world. It's been a big thrill for us to come over from Canada and commentate all dozen plus of the sports here at the World Combat Games. It's an incredible gift to see the wide diversity of martial arts throughout the world. Soft forms like Aikido, all the way down to as physical a form as you can get here with the freestyle wrestling. Athletes from all around the world.
And you welcome men's freestyle teams, Russia team and World.
Anytime two big physical men get together, grab a hold of each other and try to throw the other one on his back, we call that wrestling. But there are many, many forms of wrestling, many structures, many rule sets. This is freestyle wrestling. And you will see a lot of dynamic attacks on the legs in an attempt to get their man on the back. Freestyle wrestling, as exciting of a style of wrestling as there is. And it's going to be a lot of fun to call this. Especially sitting next to my friend Rich Tatto, former Pancration World Champion. Robin Black here in St. Petersburg, Russia, with Rich Tatto.
Great to be here, Robin.
It's gonna be good, Rich.
Oh yeah.
You know, I'm a broadcaster and I am thrilled to come over here and thrilled to commentate all these types of different types of combat sports. But I'm really happy to have you here, man, because freestyle wrestling is a very, very complex sport. It's filled with all kinds of detail and eccentricities. And I'm really going to pick your brain to help us all kind of understand what we're watching.
Yeah, you bet, man. Just tell me whatever you think, and I'll run it right by you.
All right.
But there's going to be some good matches tonight, and I'm excited to be here with you and excited to watch these tonight.
You are fairly familiar with each of these athletes, I assume, traveling through international competition?
Yeah, most of them. The Russian national team, I know a few of the big names, obviously.
Yep.
But it's exciting to see what they brought in, the world team, competing against them. So
we have, first up, Salsipov from Russia. So what are we looking at here? They're both coming in quite low.
Yeah, Russia's pretty good with position. Stay hands down. Good down blocking right there. You see that heavy hand coming in. They are going to stay low and attack. They're just solid position people here.
And we're starting with the smallest weight division, and we'll build up to the largest. Am I right?
Yeah, it's correct.
Now, so we see some pulling down on the head. Is that to get a reaction, have them kind of overreact, and then go for the legs?
Heavy hands. It's movement, putting weight on their opponent, just kind of wearing them down, and then setups. See how he's going in? A little underhook there, heavy hand, underhook, heavy hand, underhook, and just kind of move them around there.
Now, these guys are going to have a lot in the gas tank, so to speak, right? Like, they're not going to fatigue super fast.
No, these guys are on, 3 minutes straight is tough. You're going three and then three, just that little minute break, if that.
But the smaller guys can handle the pace probably a little more, right?
You'd be surprised. I mean, some of these big guys are coming in, especially, right around 84. They're going to be pretty tough. But wrestling as a whole, you're in pretty good condition for this.
And these guys have been doing this for a lifetime at this stage, right? To be this level of elite, you've got to start as a little kid, basically.
All these guys did. You're talking three, four years old. I mean, it's just incredible.
Yeah. So now, what's the game with their heads here? Is somebody trying to get beneath the chin? Is someone trying to get the head to respond? When we see these two heads together kind of competing, what are they after?
Right now, they're just in a collar tie, ear to ear, pretty neutral. You want to kind of move your opponent around to open up positions. Attacking is what you're looking at. I mean, you definitely don't want to just sit there. So there's a whistle right now. And what he's doing is telling the Russian that he needs to open up a little bit. Next one will be a caution.
And so what are some of the real basic goals to understand for the audience to be looking for here? What are some of the big techniques we'll see out of these guys? So that single leg. Right?
Single leg attack right there. Not sure why the referee just called that, but.
Now you work as a referee.
Yes.
And how tough is it to get in here and stay there? So he drops down and he picks up that single. And he'll want to do what with that? Chest pressure?
Absolutely. Just sit there, sit low, and finish that. You don't want to stay down on your knees or anything like that. So he came up right away. Really good technique.
And when you're reffing in here, this is happening pretty quick. What are some of the things you watch for as a referee?
Your attacks. This is freestyle. So you're looking for just exposure. There's no control needed in freestyle. Whereas, your collegiate style wrestling, you have to gain control to get your points. And right here, you're just looking at somebody just holding on in a front headlock, looking to gain that position or exposure.
And from that front headlock position, what do we want to do? We want to pass that kind of outstretched arm and access the back. Am I right?
Yeah, you're going to pass them by, try to get control, and then go for a turn right away. Especially on a national level, points are very slim. You'll see this scored probably, 3-4 points max, unless you got somebody turning them right away in a gut or a leg lace.
And since everybody at this level are going to be in great shape, this first round, strategically, is somebody trying to test the other, wear them out a bit?
Yeah, first period is a battle, but first period is a lot of feeling that person out. Movement, head movement, level changing. You want to get to know your opponent a little bit, similar to sparring.
Yes. So see where he may either be a little weak or where he may overreact to the pressure you're giving him and find out what opening might pop up.
Correct. You're just moving around, and you keep that constant motion. Now this period, you'll see a lot of opening up. You're looking at 1-0 right now, and you will just see a lot of attacks now.
So for you, refereeing and judging and this kind of stuff, do you enjoy traveling around the world, getting on a plane, flying over to Russia, and being here do this?
Yeah, this was a trip. This was a great trip. The sport of Cord World Combat Games are just awesome. I was honored to be a referee here, and just blessed to even be sitting with you. Look at this.
Man, it's an honor for me to be able to commentate these brilliant sports, you know, and it's tough when you come in here. You want to be able to get across to the average person what they're watching here, how beautiful this is, but you're also aware that some people who love to watch a sport like freestyle wrestling are already very educated. That's why I really thank you for being here with me.
Yeah, you bet. This is fun. I wouldn't miss this for the world. Came out here for grappling pancreation and got a treat with Greco, the other day, women's freestyle yesterday, and now today, men's freestyle. There's an attack by the Russian right now. And leg up, 2 points right there. Takedown, looking for a gut.
So he'll try to get him back to his feet and slam him, or what's
No, he's going to just turn him. All he got to do is exposure right now.
And how much time does he have there to make that happen?
Usually the ref sees progression. If he doesn't see progression within any between 5 to 10 seconds, he'll blow the whistle, bring him right back up to their feet.
So he was sort of suggesting that he was going to use that single to throw him, and then when he reacted, he went to the back.
Yeah, right away. Single leg he attacked, got his takedown, went right to a gut, low gut. Couldn't turn him, so the ref saw that.
But he's ahead now, and the Russian team is ahead.
Yes, that was a takedown too, so he's ahead 2-1 right now.
So Zeltsepov goes up for Russia, 2-1.
Straight on a takedown.
So we go into 6 minutes, and at the end of 6 minutes, we move to the next team member?
Yes, that's correct. 2 3-minute periods, got a minute in between the periods. Usually, wipe them down, and get towels on the side. Coaches a little talk to them, little massage on their arm, get those blood flowing a little bit, and right back into
it. Right back at it, now looking for the single.
Now you see his opponent attacking, mm-hmm. He's looking for a stall now, too.
Zeltsepov, though, defending pretty well, right? Getting his hips back.
Absolutely. Great down blocks, hands down.
And now goes in for the high.
There's that
crush.
Single leg attack. Comes in, good defend, heavy hips.
Stays with it, though.
Heads up, boom, takedown. Nice.
Beautiful.
Single leg to a high lift.
That was the second and third effort, staying with it when it looked like he'd be defended.
Just a great lift from that single leg. Scores 4-1 now, Russia.
What weight are these guys? Do you know?
No, I think this is 63. 60 keys.
60 keys. 132 pounds. I've got a training partner in Toronto, Adrian Woolley. Do you know that little fella?
Oh, no, I don't.
He was a Canadian champion. And at that size, he's this size. And these guys, it's unbelievable when you see them in there with 170, 180 pounder, how a high-level wrestler can take those guys down.
Oh, yeah. This is tough. We're coming into 30 seconds left in the match. Opponent attacking hard, rushing, down blocking, looking to re-attack.
Andrei Dukov of the world team, down 4-1 here.
Comes in on a single leg attack also.
So now
Russian defending it well, defending.
Oh, look at this.
There you go, there's two.
Crucifix.
Got that leg hooked. Oh, he didn't give it to him.
No.
Did not.
Well, yes, they did. They added
go.
It later. So Russia ahead 4-3.
That's the end of the match. Winner.
So we have one for Russia. The first team to four will win this team contest. But we will see all seven matches, regardless of how quickly we get there.
Absolutely. Getting exciting here.
What do we see here? Shoots in on that single.
Yeah, it came through outside. That's an outside single. Came up with it. Tabled the leg straight up to a gut. That one was just a single leg, had on the outside lift. Hard lift, low shoulder, tried to get him to his back.
And how's he defending there? He's trying to come up, but he leaves his leg, or he leaves his arm out and gets crucifixed.
Yeah, he knew, Zeltsepov knew right away that he was going down, so he didn't want to expose his back. If you go to your feet to your back, it's 3 points, and you don't want to expose that right away, so I'd rather give up the two than give that extra point.
Right, and ends up winning by only giving up the two. So Zeltsepov for Russia, Russia ahead 1-0. And we will move to, that was the 55, we will move to the 60s now. Still small and lightning fast, and we'll have the wrestling men's freestyle team, Russia, ahead 1-0 as we go into the 60 kilogram match. Robin Black here with my friend Rich Tado from Chicago, Illinois. We have Bogomev for Russia versus Velikov for the world team. Rich Tado, USA Collegiate Wrestling Coach, former Pancration World Champion. Good to have you, man.
Great being here. Some great matches coming up. You're gonna see some really good techniques, solid position, heavy hands, European style wrestling.
And at this stage, are the Russians at the very highest level in world competition?
Absolutely, this team's tough.
And so the world team is made up of teams from around the world, but predominantly Eastern Europe, and they've tried to find like very solid opponents for each of these Russians.
Yeah, I noticed it's Eastern Europe. You don't see any Asian members.
North Americans.
They just picked this team from the region around here to compete.
And all of these guys at this level have faced each other a number of times, right? In their life, most of them?
Oh, I'm sure. This is a small knit community. These guys probably even train together once in a while. You're talking year-round training with these guys. This is what they do.
Obviously, one thing we see about wrestlers, freestyle wrestlers, super explosive, super well-muscled. So they start to learn, they understand nutrition, they understand weight cutting, strength and conditioning. What parts of them do they kind of face injury? What's the common wrestler injury?
Shoulders. Yeah. I mean, you'll get shoulders. Shoulders and knees are your two common injuries. A lot of banging around. Training is tough. You know, you get a tough training partner and you're constantly banging away. Take a little bit of break, but for the most part, it's probably the toughest sport to train, to compete at, especially at this level. This is the highest level you're going to get right here.
One thing I noticed from, exploring a lot of different combat sports in my life and loving it is the wrestlers are very much the alpha males. You know, you go and you train a little Muay Thai, you get these very clever guys. You get guys who are really tough, able to take a shot. You train a little bit of jiu-jitsu, and you get some guys who love to be, work some fancy stuff, very smart. The wrestlers are the alpha males in every room.
Oh my gosh, yeah. Talk about chips on your shoulder.
And then at this level, these two guys will be elite alpha males, so they'll fear nobody and nothing.
Absolutely. Their training is just sick. They go after it hard every day.
So much like we saw in the first match here, Bogomev and Velikov, these two kind of pushing it. Like you mentioned earlier, they're kind of testing each other, seeing how far it can go, as well as trying to wear the other one down a bit as we see a single attempt here.
Bogomev right to a single leg, just a snatch single, very similar to my friend Lee Kemp, another world champ, multiple world champ, and he just took that straight out. Straight out.
That underhook there just goes to the back, able to take it. And so he will, it looks like, come out of this first period and be ahead on the score.
Yeah, got a score there, 2-0 right now.
20 seconds left for Velikov to try to get something together.
Yeah, both wrestlers been worn too, so they need to keep at it. About 10 seconds left in the match.
And every one of these 14 athletes. These 14 athletes will all be training year-round. So nobody's been, unprepared for this. They're going to be in the best shape.
Oh, yeah. These guys are top level. Absolutely. You go into their training centers, and you would just be amazed at what they can do. And it's only 6 minutes. You say, three minutes here, 3 minutes there. It's 6 minutes of just pounding.
And it's anaerobic, so it's like that lactic acid just builds up in the body and it really wears down on these guys. Let's take a look at that single again.
There you go, snatch single, brings it up.
How's he doing defending this? He's doing the right thing?
Right there, he tried to square him up, tried to get a whizzer in on there and defend it, but Bogomev just took that corner, drove right in, lift that leg right up, he went down.
And he's ahead 2-0. Second period of the second match.
Still guys fighting heavy hands, or ear to ear, looking at. They're pummeling inside hard. I mean, that is just.
That's gotta wear down on you too.
Oh yeah.
And I mean, these guys are in basically arms races and horse races as far as trying to stay as high level of conditioning as their opponents around the world. Is Russia known for their top level conditioning?
Yeah, Russia's known for a lot of things. I mean, they're gonna stay in position the whole time, keep hand fighting. They're very good at hand fighting, very good at staying for their down blocks, reattacking on attacks. They're, you know, the shot reshot type of attacks from them.
Strategically, let's say you're in Velikovsko.
Oh, nice single leg. He defended well again.
Velikov's been defending well, but let's say you're he's trains with you and you're in his corner. What strategically could he be looking to do to try to score some points here offensively?
Against the Russian?
Yeah, against the Russian.
You know what? Your setups for him are going to be tough, but for him, you're going to have to go hard. You're going to have to go inside, hit that single leg on him. You're not going to come into a double leg. You're not going to hit him with a Jordan Burroughs blast because he's just staying down. And there he goes again, attacks a single leg. Same thing, just a snatch single leg to right into a gut. Now he's looking for a leg lace, stepping over. Defended well, back up to their feet.
The grittiness of the sport, just you can really see it because Velikov defending so well throughout here, but Bogomab just will not stop.
No, that was relentless. Shot after shot after shot, shot, reshot, shot, reshot. He's just setting them up.
And if you're imagining doing that, like you said, for 6 minutes, it's not only 6 minutes, it's a long time.
Yeah, it's a long time. And these guys are hand fighting hard. 60 keys, they are fighting hard.
You see Bogomov really drag him downwards with the head. It's that hand on the back of the head, that heavy hands, that's got to distract you, it's got to wear you out, it's got to sometimes, you know, make you overreact one way or the other.
It's tiring, and that's exactly what he's doing. He's wearing him down. There he goes again, snatch single, boom, same single leg three times right there.
And those, you can't imagine outside of a Hollywood movie, Velikov coming back and scoring 6 points on this Russian in 30 seconds.
No, not a chance. Now, especially with his position.
It's that same single all the way down and just commits to it.
Just a snatch single. Doesn't even go down.
So Velikov either for pride can look for another a point here.
And that's where his heavy hand comes in. Heavy hand comes in, banging underhook to a snatch single.
Scott, low single.
Yep, opponent came in on a low single. He's stuck behind him right now.
Oh, look
at the spin out of it.
Yeah.
And he does. There's
beautiful
two.
Work.
That's it.
And that's wrestling to me. When you see a guy, you're in danger, and you flip the switch, and all of a sudden you're on the back, and you're the one scoring.
Tech fouled him right there.
Wow. That is a clean win for Russia. They go up 2-0 here in the men's freestyle at the Sport Accord World Combat Games.
That was a good match. Even though he controlled it pretty well, he fought that pretty hard.
Let's take a look at this. So this was really the story, that low single.
Low single, head on the inside, great technique. Came back, ran the pipe, took him right down.
Spirited defense all the way through, but he was not gonna be stopped today. Bogomev, clean win, as clean as you can get, but that's a hard, hard fought 5 minutes and 57 seconds.
Absolutely. Conditioning, there you go with your conditioning.
You see the amount of impact there, ear to ear, cheek to cheek. It's so much more, I think, violent than the average person realizes, that every inch is a fight. Robin Black, happy to be with you here at the Sport Accord World Combat Games with Rich Tahoe, former Pancration World Champion, referee, judge, and here my broadcast partner for the men's freestyle, Russia versus the world team. Russia is ahead 2-0, best of seven.
Great to be here with you, Robin. This is awesome.
Yeah, I'm having a good time, man.
Thanks for having me out, man.
Oh, thanks for being here. We're seeing some really good matches, eh?
These are tough. These are great matches.
I'm a Canadian, so sometimes I end a question with A.
Hey? I know well. I spent a couple weeks with you guys.
Ilyas Burkbulatov. Burkbulatov against Mustafayev of the world team.
You're announcing those names pretty good, much better than me.
Burkbulatov now trying to initiate early for Russia. The Russian team in the red.
Great defense by the world team right there. Russia took a nice shot. World team just spun right out of it.
Mustafayev here for the world team. What will they get here? A warning for inactivity? Passivity?
Nope, just a verbal warning at first.
A reset. Now, if you're the world team and you all are very familiar with how dominant this Russian team is, are you thinking defense in this first period here?
Right now you're looking for position, seeing what your opponent's moving. Little open up in weaknesses. Again, you're coming in. Hand fighting is big at the beginning. Hand fight, heavy hands. Sounds like I'm repeating, but that's what you're looking for. And then as his head pops up, you're looking for your shots.
And what are some of the subtleties in here with the hand fighting?
Just pummeling inside. You don't want to have your opponent control your head. So you're pummeling back inside, getting them off your head, and then looking to be counteractive with that and do the same thing.
See, the Russian takes the wrist and tries to put that in. Will that give him access to the back, or is that a distraction?
No, just getting him off his head. Yeah. I mean, you're just looking... looking for a two-on-one, especially these guys. These guys are good two-on-one opponents. Technique with that.
Two hands on one arm, on one wrist.
Yeah, and they actually call it a Russian tie, but. Yeah.
The Russian coach not super happy.
No, that was a nice shot.
Yeah.
Took an inside single leg and just.
We put pressure, hyperextended the knee.
Yeah.
So that's the hand on the back of the on the back of the heel and a bit of shoulder against the knee to hyperextend it.
Yeah, it actually came in as initially as a high crotch, and the world team member nice sprawl, but he went in on that, and I'm not sure why they blew the whistle, but still 0-0.
Yeah. This is the 66 kilogram matchup between Burkbulatov from Russia and Mustafayev from the world team. 30 seconds left in the first period, still 0-0. Russia ahead 2-0 in this men's team freestyle.
Yep, called the Russian for stalling, gave him 30 seconds to score. What that means is after the whistle blows, the Russian had 30 seconds to score on his opponent. If not, world team member gets that point, and that's exactly what happened. He could not get that score, so now the score's 1-0, is right.
Just imagine when you're looking at this, the amount of work, the back of the neck and the lower back. Oh, gets in just at the 3-minute mark.
Yep, same thing, high crotch.
All that pulling down on the back of the head, that bent over a strong stance. You imagine just the amount of wear and tear on the upper neck and the lower back here. These are young, strong guys, but what kind of life expectancy, I mean, athletic life expectancy, of course, how long can you do this?
I mean, average, wrestler at this level, which is called the senior level, you're probably looking at 26, 27. These guys, I know that the Russians, I'm not sure what age it is, but they usually retire, or actually make them retire after a certain age.
Wow. So even if you're on top of your game, whatever that age is, 27, 28, almost exclusively, that's when you'll put an end to that stage of your career.
They bring in a new member, new team, and they groom them right to be at that weight class.
Wow. Russia has been so dominant throughout all the martial arts here at the Games. Their medal count is, you know, more than many of the other teams combined, even the top teams. Their programs, their athletic programs, and the amount of commitment they have to athletics here is just huge.
Oh, yeah. Spent some time with one of the guys that has two gyms in Moscow, outside of Moscow region. But, these guys train five days a week consistently. And... the membership, he's telling me that they have well over 200 members in their gym, from jiu-jitsu to grappling to pancration, just crazy numbers.
He's in on that single again.
Yep, there it is. Tables that leg outside, comes up.
That's the second leg.
He's going to offer him a takedown or 1-point step out.
Either way, it's a point. Yeah, but Russia goes up 2-0.
Gave him a point.
Berkbulatov gets to the back and forces out Mustafiev. Goes up 2-0.
Yeah, push out. Didn't give him the takedown. Gave him the push out.
We're at almost, man, 6, 12, 15, almost 16 minutes of combat here. And you haven't seen these Russians really take a step back. It's been all offense through three different competitors here.
Forward pressure. Forward pressure in the States, you'll see teams like Iowa hit a lot of that. Iowa's very, very heavy-handed forward pressure. A Russian shot in, got his head caught on the outside. World team member takes it, but right now you're just looking at a great defense.
Wow.
There he goes again.
Force out?
Yep. No. He didn't have control, so there was actually nothing. Both guys were pretty even on that.
So he gets to the back. Look at this Russian defense. Sits back with the leg, reaches around, turns his body.
Yeah, just see that, man. These guys are just heavy. They're coming in, working position, you know.
Is this heavy-handed?
Elbow pass, heavy hands. Yeah, this is now they're just in a clinch right now, moving them around.
Yeah, you've been in this sport for a lot of years. What are some of the areas we've seen it change into the very modern era? Is some of this aggressiveness? Is it the heavy-handedness? What kind of things we've seen over the last decade?
Changes in wrestling? Not that much. I mean, you'll see a little bit more at the at the collegiate level in the States, a little more fluid. But for the most part, I mean, you just see that constant pressure, and the guys that have that constant pressure will usually wear that opponent down unless you're in great shape. I mean, you just have to be able to move out of the way, move your opponent, and be with them the whole time.
And that's been the Russian game here today through three matches.
They are tough, man. They just keep coming at you. Pummel inside, guy comes in, he pummels right back inside. Takes a few steps forward, hands down. Good down block.
Mustafiev is just, there's no quit in these guys. At this stage, it takes so much to get to this level in their lifetime. So Mustafiev just not quitting, but man, it's just so much pressure from Berkbulatov.
Absolutely, tried a couple fake shots, but that's not gonna get it. There it is, big win for Russia, 4-0.
So now we have three matches, three dominant Russian wins. And Russia is one match away from clinching this gold medal. Berkbulatov with a big win here, dominant win.
This will be a really good match right now.
Sargush of Russia.
Sargush is just an amazing wrestler, bronze medalist at the London Games, two-time gold medal world champion, European champion, three-time European champion actually, and just as a hammer. He is so strong. Lost to Burrows, I think it was in the quarters in London, but came back to win a bronze. And he's not a two-time world champion for nothing. So
Terziev, the world team, will have his work cut out for him here with Sargush.
Yes.
Now, so what are some of the aspects of his game that differentiate him from the others? Is it just his fitness and how good he is in general, or does he have a few specific go-to choices?
Actually, he's explosive. I mean, you will watch this and just be amazed how he is. Explosive in terms of he'll just float, heavy hand, move him around, and then bam, he is on you.
We are here at the Sport Accord World Combat Games. It is the men's freestyle team tournament for the gold medal, Russia versus the world. And this is Denis Sargush versus Terziev, Kirill Terziev. Sargush in the red, all the Russians are in the red, and he's already got a piece of his foot.
Yep, single leg, brings it real high, kicks that leg out. World team member tried to get out of bounds, but with the new rule changes, as a wrestler, you want the takedown now. He's got great position on him right now. He's looking for a throw. Steps in. There's your 2 points. And he's got a trapped gut. There he goes with the trapped gut.
Look at how aggressive he is.
Yep, there's points right there. Wow. No, he's got a fall, almost a fall there.
Yeah, he wants it back today. Yep. 5 points already for Sargush of Russia.
Two for takedown, exposure. There's another. Wow. Two more. That's it.
That is it.
Tech followed him.
1 minute and 10 seconds. And that is the win for Russia as they go four straight and take this men's freestyle team gold medal. We will see three more exciting matches between six of the best athletes here, but Russia will win the gold. Sargush.
Yeah, that was sick, man. Came right in, single leg, fought, defended. He countered with his single leg, jumped right into a trapped arm gut and just kept going, hit it once, hit it twice, and got him right to his back. Sick, he's just amazing.
Let's take a look at it again. So he is now on the back here. What are the key things he's working? I see Terziev try to hip out there. What's going on here?
Tried to hip out, but he had his arm trapped. So he had a pretty tight gut with an arm. So right there, he's got that arm. Hits him once, hits him twice, wow. And he just rolls it through. And in freestyle, again, you don't have to hold him there for anything. All you have to do is exposure.
Wow.
Exposed his back.
The goal is dominance, and that was dominance. Robin Black here with you with Rich Tato, former Pancration World Champion. We're here at the Sport Accord World Combat Games, and we are here for the Men's Freestyle Team Gold Medal Contest, Russia versus the world. And as we enter the fifth match, Russia has already taken the gold. So three more matches to go. The three big Russians will look for a sweep, and the world team will look for a small victory here somewhere, somehow.
At least to get one win here, but another good match coming up.
Shakhrudinov versus Stefan. Shakhrudinov, now his teammates have all been dominant. They've all won, and he wants to keep that going.
Now we're getting big. These guys, 84 keys. Now you're getting up there now. Still gonna see that pounding, forward pressure. See that movement he has, pushing on that head, heavy hand, back of the head.
So Rich, I'm talking about the size of these guys, 84 kilograms. You know, in the West, athletes will cut a lot of weight, even when they're competing, you know, a few times a month. But what about out here in international competition? What do we see in terms of weight cutting?
You know, most of these guys are wrestling year round, so they kind of live close to this weight. You're only talking probably at the most 5 keys that they're differentiating at. And you lose 5 keys, you know, in a practice, believe it or you know, a couple practices, believe it or not. So.
And then after they rehydrate after weighing in, they can put back 2 or 3 kilos.
Yeah, fluids. I mean, mostly fluids because you're not at this level. You don't want to cut any type of food. You want to keep that muscle tone and definitely the energy level.
Stefan of the world team trying to get aggressive, trying to get underneath that leg.
He's got a little stoppage in action here, you know.
It's been going just crazy through 4 matches, so no shortage of action.
Now, these guys are pushing hard. Big time elbow pass, though. You know, world team members coming in for, they're that arm drag right there to a single leg, pulls them up. Takes a Russian right down.
And takes
2 points right there.
The lead in the first period here. That is the first world team lead that we've seen yet. Stefan goes ahead 2-0 over Shakhrudinov of Russia. St. Petersburg, just one of the most beautiful cities in the world, eh?
Oh my gosh, yeah. I wish I had another day. You know, my trip was planned by the Sport Accord Games, so I didn't have that choice of staying an extra day, but I did have a little time to get out there and enjoy it. Got to see some of the famous churches. And,
it's absolutely
good time.
I don't know if you've had an opportunity to taste the Russian standard vodka, but it is delicious.
Yeah, I was actually treated by a few of the high-ranking FILA referees, freestyle Greco referees last night. So,
oh, very nice.
Yeah, very, very, very great guys. Had a great time.
So now for people who love watching athletics but don't compete around the world like that, you know, you competed, these guys are competing. Later, you can move into coaching, guys can move into refereeing, judging. You know, how many countries have you traveled all around the world with this sport?
Yeah, you know, I've been pretty lucky with it. Got invited here. I've done referee 2 world championships. You know, just just had some good good luck. But again, wrestling, you know, you're at the right place at the right time.
Yeah.
And wrestling has definitely given me those opportunities.
Yeah, I mean, getting to commentate something like this, travel around the world and look at a beautiful sport with elite athletes, it's just, we're very lucky people. And these guys, these athletes here, enjoy that aspect now, and they'll move into other areas when they retire.
Oh, yeah. I mean, look at this. You know, 2 weeks ago, I'm just thinking I'm going to, you know, referee this, and now I'm here refereeing and have the pleasure and just great opportunity to commentate with you. So.
And what's happened right here? Shakur Dinov.
Yep. Defended a double leg, came back in. He reshot, took it right in, and took him right to his back. Double leg right to his back.
And with 2 seconds to go, that was an important 2 points here in the first period. Bear gets him within striking range.
Yeah, scores 3-4 now. Russia's down 3-4 in the match.
Georgita Stefan here of the world team. The first time that a world team member has been ahead here today. Russia already with the gold. They won 4 straight, best 4 of 7. But Stefan here ahead by 1 point going into the second period.
Yeah, this will be a good match. For these guys being as big as they are moving, you know, very good. Low shots. Again, they're going from elbow passes to arm drags, except for that last takedown by the Russian.
Shakur Dinov, the Russian in the red, and Stefan from the world team in the blue. And Stefan shoots immediately and pays for it.
Yeah, head down. Russian came in, down block, went right to a gut. Right there, there's that gut. 2 points.
1 second, you're up 4-3. The next second, you're down 7-4.
Yeah.
That was a painful one.
Don't shoot with your head down.
Yeah. And just a straight arrow right there, right?
That's it. Shot with his head down. It's perfect down block spin right behind.
If this was baseball, that would be an arrow.
That was bad.
And one mistake in this sport. One mistake takes you from up 4-3 to down 7-4, and the momentum shifts to Shakur Dinov from Russia.
Yep, now you're just going to see a lot of strategy. He's going to be down there, hands down. There's that double leg again.
Wow.
Russia, boom. Nice.
Shakur Dinov might have heard an earful from his coach there. These guys want a sweep for Russia.
Yeah, he just lowered his level and just a blast double straight in. Sweet.
And his coach, I think, just told him to keep attacking. That's the way Russia seemed to like it here through 4.5 matches. And he does.
He is. He's still attacking. Still attacking hard. Coming in, banging that head, and changing levels.
What about faking that shot? You'll fake it to be able to get a man to commit to a type of defense and use that position to attack.
Oh, yeah. It's a great setup. You know, again, I'll refer to the 74-pound Jordan Burr, or 74-key Jordan Burroughs gold medals from London. He's just got a sick blast double, and, you know, comes from that fake shot.
Mm.
You know, they'll fake a couple shots, and next thing you know, he's in on those legs. But, you know, he is the best in the world at it.
In any combat sport, getting your man there, forcing him, teaching him to expect something and giving him the opposite is really the key to scoring in any combat.
Yeah, just, you know, setups. And that's one of the biggest setups right there for that.
Wow, that was quick. It's still attacking.
That was an amazing scramble. One from a double leg, you know, had that down block, underhook, brought him back up. He reshot, he underhooked him, brought him back up. That is that conditioning right there is just amazing.
We are in the 84-kilogram match here between Shakur Dinov and Stefan of the world team. Russia already won the gold with 4 straight, and they want a sweep here. Stefan was ahead after the first period, but very quickly Shakur Dinov just has seemingly put it almost out of reach.
Yeah, now it's going to be tough.
And what is the strategy here? I mean, you can't just attack, or you're going to give up even more points. Wow, it's just going to force this out.
Yep, high single, just pushed him right out. 1 point push out.
And up now 10-4.
Yeah, you know, the Russian is not giving up. I mean, he just, that's their technique. I mean, that's their style. They just want to attack.
10 seconds left. There's the first fake shot from Stefan, trying to now get the Russian to react, but way too little too late. Shakhrudinov keeps the Russian streak going as they take the fifth match here in the 84 kilograms at the men's freestyle team. The Russians have won the gold medal. They have been dominant through five. Robin Black and Rich Tato here having a good time.
Great being here, this is awesome. Wouldn't miss it for the world.
Look at that, right underneath, right to the back. They make it look easy for someone who's never wrestled in their life. They don't understand that each one of these inches is a little battle, right?
Absolutely. And you know, I teach this at all levels. Your windows of opportunity are big when you're younger. As you get older, those windows, you know, they close and close and close. At this level, you're talking about a second to react to get to that. I mean, that's how small that window of opportunity is.
Wow, he just ran that one right down.
That's a blast double. You're not gonna, it's a freight train coming right at you.
And I think that was a statement for the next two. So we're here for wrestling men's freestyle competition, team competition. The gold medal already won by Russia, but it has been a great, great day of matches. It's the World Combat Games, Sport Accord World Combat Games. We're in St. Petersburg, Russia. Rich Tato and Robin Black. And we go to the big boys, Rich.
Yeah, here we go. You're talking 96 keys. These are some monsters.
Gadasov, the Russian in the red. Yankuski, Ivan Yankuski from the world team.
Gadasov straight right away, just that down block position. Coming forward. Hand fighting. Amazing.
He's trying to get in on, oh, look at that. Pulling now on the left arm and then diving through, trying it on the single on the right leg.
He had a 2-on-1 pass that went to the opposite leg. Good counter by the world team member here.
Yankuski of the world.
Elbow pass right to an outside single. Look at that.
Oh.
Takedown. That was a sick elbow pass.
And this is match number six, and it starts the way the previous five have. To be honest, Stefan of the world team started a little faster in the fifth match, but one through four, and now here in match number six, it's the Russian draw in first blood.
Right away, came right at him.
So Yankuski here taking a slightly different approach with that head control. What was he looking for there?
Just came right in, heavy hand, right to a front headlock. Both were standing up, so it wasn't a lot of pressure on him, but he right away attacks from that. And counter. I mean,
Yankuski trying to get aggressive.
There he goes again. Elbow pass right to that single, took him right down.
So when you're coaching these young guys at the collegiate level in the States, what about mentality? Like, are they coming in here always aggressive? Sometimes are they trying to conserve or trying to take different strategies? Or is it really about dominance and aggression almost always in this sport?
Yeah, you know what? It is a pretty mental game. Everybody thinks that you're going to come right out. The strongest guy is always going to win. But, you know, a lot of it has to do with your attitude stepping on that mat and where you want to be. Hopefully, at the collegiate level, you get guys that are, you know, conditioned in the same manner. But when you come and you have that attitude that you don't want to lose and you're just going to, you know, come heavy at that guy, you have the upper hand when you're, you know, when you think opposite, just like anything else in life. You know, you got to be. That's why wrestlers are tough. And wrestlers just don't want to quit.
Some beautiful action in here, and Yankuski does get to the back and get to the mat. And these Russian guys, they just seem so mentally tough. They're physically tough, obviously. They're very skilled, but today we're seeing a real example of that. They're just attacking. And oddly, these days, North America and Europe, we see in almost every sport psychology is an element. in Russia, sports psychology is just run a bit more, work a little harder, don't you think?
Oh, the coaches are with these guys. You know, you just said it earlier about starting at a young age. Don't forget, these coaches know these kids from, you know, probably 7-8 years old. And so they get used to them and keep on them and keep on them, know their tendencies, mm-hmm. Know how to motivate them.
Gattisov has twice looked for the double underhooks chest to chest. What would he be looking to do from there?
Still the same thing. Nice try, duck under right there, countered, brought him right up. That was a great first period. Yeah, tough, man. Look at him. Yeah. He's tired.
Both took some deep breaths there.
Oh, yeah.
Three hard minutes. That is beautiful. Looks to the sky.
Sick duck under right to a gut.
Oh, that
took him right down.
Incredible athleticism, timing. Yeah, he was looking for that fireman's carry style reach.
Yeah, came in with a high crotch, stepped behind.
Nice.
Smart. Just went right down. Rather give up two than get thrown like that.
And the two are the only two so far. 2 seconds left. They'll be right back in here. And you're not going to recover that much in 25 seconds.
No.
Still breathing hard. He's got 3 hard minutes of work. What I think is hard for people to understand about this kind of anaerobic output is basically lean as hard as you can against the wall and try to run and push that wall until it goes and do that for 3 minutes. Look at that reach.
Oh, that was a sick over-the-head fireman's carry, but countered really good by the world team member.
Yankuski, the world team is defending, but he's also taking the deeper breaths of the two. And Gattisov, the Russian, is going to try to feast on that now.
Yeah, they're both pretty tired. You can see that they're tired, but they're still going to battle inside. Being down 4 points, you got to make some action. You only have 2.5 minutes left to get after it. So you got to be the guy on the offense.
And right now, that's the Russian Gattisov. But yeah, get an average person to try to literally push a car up a hill that's in park for 3 minutes and see how they feel.
Yeah. Just hand fighting alone, we do that for about 2 minutes at a time and just practice that just to get the feel going of what it's like to actually hand fight. And you'll see these guys just completely worn out in 10 minutes. I mean, just wiped out.
And when you, now retired coaching, when you get it, that's beautiful.
That was it. That's a fall right there. Boom.
And that was simple pressure on the lower back and driving the shoulder in. And he just, was it the getting in that was the key to that?
Yeah, he just went to an opposite side duck, came under, bear hugged him, took him right to his back. It's a touch fall. Boom, done.
Wow. Very dominant. Look at the shape that kid's in.
He's a beast.
It's ridiculous.
Dude.
Definitely the best conditioned athletes here at the games. Gattisov.
Right there. Duck under, squeeze, bear hug him right to his back. Step behind, boom.
Little rotation to his own right. Just finishes. Oh, that is sick. You're right. Because that's just not a normal man. That is a high, high level wrestler. And he was able to get such a clean takedown here. Just drives,
he had
turns
so
to his
tight.
Right. Oh, it's badass.
Just shows you how, keeping that pressure on, Even though he was up by 4 points, he wasn't wrestling the rest of the match not to lose. He was out there to wrestle to win no matter what.
So we are here at the Sport Accord World Combat Games. It is the men's freestyle team gold medal contest. It is already done. Russia has won all 6, but we have a big, big fight with big, big men. And the world team is fighting for a little respect. And the Russian team, Magomedov, is fighting for the clean sweep. 6 wins for Russia, 6 dominant wins. Men's freestyle.
They are wrestling tough, I tell you.
And here we see the final matchup, 120 kilograms. I don't know how good my math is. I think that is 6,457 pounds.
When you try to wrestle somebody at 120 keys, it feels like that truck you're talking about not moving.
We just got word that it's actually 264.55 pounds, so I was off by about 6,000. But they are big dudes. And they're skilled athletes, skilled conditioned athletes.
Oh gosh, yeah, these guys are athletes. These guys can move. you know, maybe not as like a 66 key, but definitely they move, you know, same as 84 pound or 84 key guys.
Wow. 264 pounds, 120 kilograms. Magomedov, the Russian, in the red. Zebizov from the world team in the blue from Azerbaijan. Zebizov wants this win badly to take one for the world team. Russia 6-0 in the final match. Russia has already won the gold.
Yeah, and you look at Magomedov from Russia. He's at 264 pounds. He is in good shape. I mean, that's not a guy that has a lot of fat on him.
529 pounds right here face to face. Now you're a ref. I don't know what this referee can expect from these two giant monsters, but I guess they need to work a little more.
Yeah, you know what? At this weight, you just don't want them to keep their heads down, so they're going to come in heavy on that head too and slow everything down a little bit, but you as a wrestler have to work out of that, and if you keep your head down, they'll call you for stalling.
Yeah. What did he give up there looking for the single?
Just right there. Went from a front headlock. Took the Russian right down from a front headlock and spun right behind him.
So Zebizov with 2 points for the world team here in the final matchup. He'll have to settle for two.
Yeah. Tried that gut, but he wasn't moving.
Let's see here. So he defended the single and immediately went to the back. So he went against the arm that was tripoded, so he was able to access the back much easier.
Yep, front headlock, opposite side, trapped that arm. Front head, and just blocked and went behind.
Technical is not generally the word you imagine when you look at the size of these guys, but they are highly trained technical athletes.
Yeah, that was just your
textbook
takedown right there.
So when you see Magomedov trying to come in under that chin, is he trying to use his forehead under the chin for any? Oh, dives for
that. That was nice. It was a high crotch right to a double leg. Took him down. Now he's looking to finish it. But, you know, nice counter by the world team member.
Drove his hip to the ground to free the other hip and go belly down. And now he looks for points.
Yep. No points at all. That was nice. Nice counter.
5 seconds remaining in the first period. They'll both need this break.
Yeah, that Russian is a big guy.
Wow, no kidding. You do not take his dessert.
No, you know, 120 keys. I'm sure he can eat a lot of, you know, I had the pleasure of meeting Alexander Karelin the other day, came into St. Petersburg for these games, and he's just an amazing man, still just a giant among boys, I tell you.
Well, we've called everything from throughout these games all the way to sumo, and those athletes are immense, but these guys are gigantic in their own right. Now, here we find period two of the final matchup in the men's freestyle team contest. Russia has won, but Zebizov of Azerbaijan, representing the world team, is up 2-0. If he can win, it will be a small victory for the world team, and it will prevent a sweep by Russia. And Magomedov will be desperate to represent Russia.
He's moving well. World team member is moving well, countering really well, so he's going to have to put some pressure on him.
Wow, he committed to it, but he gave up his back again.
Nah, that was bad. That was just a bad shot. Just dove right for the leg. At this level, you dive for that leg, you're going down.
So what should he have done? Change his level and got the leg down and drove all the way through?
Yeah, for somebody that big, you got to hit a corner. If you don't hit the corner on somebody that big, he's just going to sprawl on you like he did. And he flattened him out. Right when he hit the mat, he flattened out. He went right behind him.
So Zebizov of the world team up 4-0 in this final match. second period of the last match, 2 minutes remaining in the whole team tournament here. And Zabizov trying to take the last match for the world team. Magomedov, he needs to go after this for Russia for the clean sweep. And he does.
I tell you, he moves well. Beautiful. Magomedov has his hands full, I tell you.
Defended that well. Aslan Zabizov, I am sorry, of the world team from Azerbaijan here, up 4-0.
Yeah, and he only has about a minute and a half to get after it right now.
That's going to be tough. And it's, I mean, look how big these athletes are, moving around, exerting at this level, but also carrying another 264 pounds on top of you at times. Insane. Tries to duck under.
You know, they keep the same training regimen as the smaller guys, so they're in good shape. They may be a little bit heavier, but you know, they're in really good shape.
1 minute remaining. Men's freestyle team. This is the gold medal match. It's already been won by Russia, but Zabizov from Azerbaijan representing the world team, looking for a little respect here, and up 4-0.
Yeah, 45 seconds, he's got to get after, down 4-0. That's going to be hard to score then on that. He may have the only upset on the world team.
That's definitely the strategy here. That's what he came in here for in this final match. ...20 seconds left, and it looks like this one will be taken by Aslan Zabizov for the world team. Russia gonna give one up here, and he goes for it with the last 5 seconds, looking to go behind and score one more time.
Oh, close. Wouldn't have mattered, though. Nope. I mean, that would have only given him two, but he got the upset.
Yeah, Aslan Zabizov from Azerbaijan, representing the world team. That's a little victory here at the end. Obviously not enough. Russia will win this. 6-1.
Yeah, great match.
Russia with the gold medal here. Dominant, absolutely dominant here throughout this men's freestyle team contest. And let's take a look at the action.
Yeah, just right away. That was easy. You know, you shoot with your head down, push the head down, textbook, sprawl hard, hips down, went goal right behind. And like I said, you know, these guys, they look big, but man, they move fast.
Yeah. So it was a great, great men's freestyle team contest. The Russians win the gold medal. And it was really great being here in St. Petersburg at the World Combat Games. I want to thank you, Rich Tatto, for coming in from Chicago. You're here to ref, but it was a great pleasure having you here. Thank you so much, my man.
Robin, actually, it's been my pleasure. It was a great time. Actually, one of my first chances to do a little commentary.
Well,
thank you very much.
You did it like a pro, my friend. So that is it. Robin Black signing off here at the World Combat Games, Sport Accord World Combat Games in St. Petersburg, Russia. The gold medal for the men's freestyle team here. Some great matches. Thank you so much.
second place silver medalist is Team of Fila. Золотым медалистом и чемпионом всемирных игр боевых искусств становится команда Gold Medalist and World Combat Games Champions in Freestyle Wrestling is Team of the Russian Federation. Победителей соревнований вручается тренеру сборной команды Российской Федерации. Team Cup is presented to the coach of the national team of the Russian Federation, Магомеду Гусейнову. Дамы и господа, прошу всех встать. Звучит гимн Российской Федерации. Now, ladies and gentlemen, please stand up for the national anthem of the Russian Federation. Российской Федерации.